Hi, Maker. It's Charlotte with Makesy.
Joanna with the Soap Gal.
Makesy is so excited to have partnered with Joanna and the Soap Gal in order to help makers be safe, successful, and scale their cold process soap making businesses. Today, we're talking about an important topic, and it's something critical in order to make soap. And that is our friend, lye, also known as sodium hydroxide. So today, Joanna is going to talk us through a little bit about what lye is and how to use lye, including a couple of terms like water discounting, lye discounting, so on and so forth, that will help you understand how to formulate cold process soap. So Joanna, take it away.
In order to make bar soap, you have to use sodium hydroxide. Most makers, and the way I was taught, was that you use one part sodium hydroxide to two parts or more of the liquid of your choice. And I started out making goat's milk soap. So when I first started making soap, I, you know, milked my goats, and then I turned that milk into
Not
ice.
Not everybody might have that privilege, but no, that was a special privilege.
Yes, it truly was a privilege. I miss those gals. And kids, but I would take that milk and I put it in to ice trays. I would freeze it. Then I would measure out the liquid that I needed. Let's say I needed 14 ounces of that liquid. Then I would have to weigh out my 7 ounces of my sodium hydroxide, and I would slowly pour that over the goat's milk and stir, so that way it doesn't cook too fast.
Yep.
And it was a long process, and until I learned about the 50-50 lye solution.
So that is a game changer, and that is the product that Joanna and I have taught in some of our other YouTube videos and show you guys how to use the 50-50 solution in order to make soap that cures and is ready to use and safe to use within 48 hours. So the 50-50 solution is exactly what it sounds like. It's 50% lye and it's 50% water, versus the alternative, which would be sodium hydroxide flakes or beads, which are also commonly used. So pros and cons of each.
When you are using the flakes or the beads, you don't have a liquid there that can pour on you and hurt you. So you have to respect the 50-50 lye solution. The other benefit with it is that you are able to make your soap right then. You're using the full liquid, the amount that you need. The con, though, is you're dealing with fumes. So I would suggest the toxic fumes. So I would suggest to make sure that you are in a well-ventilated area. I would also suggest to use ice water. So then that way the temperature is not so high when you're making your solution. I would also suggest that you gotta be cautious and make sure it's safe. And when you're doing that, you're still gonna have to put that in a safe protection area that will ventilated.
Absolutely. And Joanna and I also have a video that talks you guys through what PPE or personal protective equipment you do need if you are making cold process soap or you're making your own lye solution.
Right.
So the 50-50 solution, it helps speed things up a lot. And as Joanna said, eliminates any fumes while you're creating your own water lye solution if you choose that route. So that's one huge benefit.
Also, we're making a cold process, so we don't want to use 200 degree lye with our oils.
Yes.
It's at room temperature, it's already there. It's kind of like having your lye available at all times. The biggest benefit, besides it being scalable and a time saving attribute, the other thing is that you're able to play with your liquids. You could add in your aloe vera juice or your goat's milk. You are able to not just have distilled water in your soap.
Or you can choose to use all distilled water. The choice will be yours. So Joanna, walk us through when you use the 50-50 solution, kind of what the ratios are.
You have your base oils, and then you have to have your lye. And when you're doing one part lye to two parts water, you're then using your 7 ounces of lye, and then you're using your 14 ounces of water. When you have your 50-50 solution, you already have one part liquid that's dissolved your sodium hydroxide. So all you have to do is add that extra liquid. So when you're doing a 1 to 2, instead of using 7 ounces of lye, lye and 14 ounces of water. Now with your 50-50 solution, you are using your 14 ounces of lye and your 7 ounces of water. So you're just flipping the numbers.
One of the biggest benefits is that you don't lose that creativity.
No.
You can still add a floral water, an aloe vera juice, a milk. You can still have that customization power to change your formula, but you're saving yourself tons of time. And that is a really important factor to consider if you plan to sell your soaps. So think about scalability in your own manufacturing process, even if you're just making one block of soap at a time right now. This solution will help you guys in the future so that you can wait less time and make more soap and not run out when you have a customer that wants to buy your soap.
And also with these ratios, we are doing a super fat or lye discount of 6%, and we are doing a water discount of about 19%. So that way that water is not in your soap from the beginning, so then that means that water does not have to dissipate.
Which means that your soap will reach its finished weight that you'll put on your packaging sooner than if you didn't have that water discount in there. So that's what you need to know about lye and about our 50-50 solution. And you guys definitely need to check out our other videos, like on if your soap needs to cure, and do's and don'ts for using lye and making sure that you have all your PPE in place. Thank you guys so much for watching, and be sure to subscribe to our channel for all those other videos and our latest tips and tricks. Now go make it happen.